This is On Your Radio Shillong, the Northeast News Bulletin, read by Miranda Blah. The Meghalaya State Cabinet yesterday approved the amended Meghalaya Residence Safety and Security Bill 2019 in the form of an ordinance by amending the existing Act. People from outside who come in the form of tenants, labourers, tourists and with other purposes to visit or stay will have to register in their own interest as well as for the interest of Meghalaya. The decision to implement the registration process was taken by the Cabinet by amending the Meghalaya Residence Safety and Security Act 2016 to facilitate outsiders to register with the state authorities. After the meeting, Deputy Chief Minister Preston Tinsong said the state government will redraft the existing rules to ensure the simplest procedures are in place for registration, which will also be done online. Any person who fails to furnish the information will be liable for punishment under Section 176/177 of the Indian Penal Code, he added. Arunachal Pradesh Chief Minister Pema Khandu has said that law and order will always be his government's priority and our all-out efforts are being put to strengthen the police force in the state. Mr. Khandu said this after inaugurating the new office building of the Superintendent of Police in Tawang yesterday. The Chief Minister said the state government was sanctioned good amount of funds for police modernization from procuring latest equipment to meeting infrastructure gaps and manpower. Mr. Khandu said that two more police battalions of Arunachal Pradesh will be formed soon. He also said 1,000 more posts for state police force is yet to be filled up, for which recruitment will be carried out shortly. Mizoram Chief Minister Zoramthanga yesterday said the government's flagship program Socio-Economic Development Policy will ensure all-round growth of the state. Inaugurating offices of the 14 boards under SEDP at the Secretariat Building in Aizawl, the Chief Minister said the program is not a dole but rather a policy to facilitate development. The SEDP guidelines emphasize equity in economy and welfare, he said, adding that the main thrust of the land-based program would be on mass production, transportation, industry and market. The SEDP aims at accelerating progress in key sectors and transforming Mizoram into a welfare state by achieving self-sufficiency in food items. Mr. Zoramthanga said that the policy will focus on increasing the gross state domestic product of Mizoram, improving the economic condition of the general public, creating employment opportunities and bringing in sustainable development. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu yesterday inaugurated the 12-day 21st Northeast Book Fair in Guwahati in presence of Assam Governor Jagdish Mukhi, Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal and others. Underlying the importance of libraries, Vice President Naidu laid stress on the use of the mother tongue. He also highlighted the relevance of books to stir one's creativity and stimulate innovative and inventive ideas. The demographic dividend that the nation wants to achieve cannot be realized without quality books as well as improved literacy and number of readers, he said. Mr. Naidu also urged schools and parents in helping children inculcate reading habits. In this line of thought, he stressed on establishing one library per village. There are 217 bookstalls, including one from Bangladesh, in the ongoing fair in Guwahati. Chin-Kuki-Mizo Kut, a post-harvest festival popularly known as Chavang Kut, was celebrated in Manipur and Mizoram yesterday. The festival marks the Anglo-Kuki War centenary year. In the festival in Aizawl, the Chin-Kuki-Mizo tribal groups highlighted traditional social events, food and music. Chavang Kut Festival in Manipur represents an important cultural expression of the Chin-Kuki-Mizo group of people. In the past, the celebration was primarily important in the religio-cultural sense. The rhythmic movement of the dances in the festival was inspired by animals, agricultural techniques and demonstrate human relationship with ecology. For the first time, Arunachal Pradesh will host the Multilingual Writers Meet at its oldest town, Pasighat, in East Siang district from today. The two-day event will be held at the auditorium of College of Horticulture and Forestry. The Sahitya Academy, in collaboration with Central Agricultural University, Imphal and Arunachal Pradesh Literary Society, Itanagar, are hosting the meeting. 25 prominent multilingual writers and poets from all parts of India and many literary dignitaries of the host state will attend the event. And with that, we end the Northeast News Bulletin. which came to you from the Shillong station of All India Radio. Have a nice day.